I'm David Conigliaro. I'm a senior product manager at CNC Software. I'm responsible for the mill product, and that encompasses three separate teams. And collectively, we are responsible for R&D in the future, and our current efforts, and anything mill, that from two-axis to five-axis. I'm responsible for the three teams that take care of our product. Part of my job is to keep an eye on, industry trends and future needs of the product. The most valuable feedback we get does come from the users, our customers. All that feedback we can get from the customers is their voice, being heard and used to make plans for the next release. We need that voice and we rely on it. So in the multi-axis part of our software, we're very excited about the unified toolpath that combines the power of parallel and morph and a long curve and such in a single user interface. The value is the ability to iterate. And until you're comfortable with it, it takes time, of course, it's new. But once you create that comfort zone with the toolpath and you set it up and you know it as well as you knew your morph or your parallel, you will find that it's easier to iterate and be more of a creative programmer with the unified toolpath, because you can kind of switch between modes and your selections will be retained and your settings will be retained. And it's very freeing. It can be shocking and jarring at the same time to see morph and parallel and a long curve, to see these toolpaths removed. But there's a method here, and there's more to come past Mastercam 2023, and we continue to realize our end goal. This was just step one. Detecting undercut stock in Mastercam 2023 has been a long time coming. We understand the need, we've understood the need, and we finally have been able to implement it in the Mastercam 2023 without our customers feeling it, as in processing time taking significantly longer. So in the past, Mastercam only saw the remaining stock basically down the Z-axis. It did not understand when the tool broke through the stock. It would continue to machine and cut air. So when you turn on detect undercut stock, Mastercam treats the stock as a three-dimensional shape, and the tool will break through the material and it will stop milling. And that's going to make our customers' programming experience so much more streamlined and simple, especially any customers doing complex part machining from a 3+2 approach. 3+2 machining, it's a lot of breakthrough, and you're coming through from different angles, and our customers had to do a lot of work to create Z limits or blocking surfaces so the tool didn't keep going. In Mastercam 2023, there's nothing extra to do. You turn on detect undercut stock, and the tool is going to approach the stock, I'll say logically, as a human being would understand to approach the stock. The tool broke through the stock, stop cutting. And we made it a checkbox on the stock page in an effort to be able to keep old files clean. So when the old files come in, the detect undercut checkbox will be off so that you have no fear of your old files doing something strange on you. And if you desire to continue to work like that, because you've got some approaches and some habits and some patterns, you can continue to work without detect undercut. It's an option. So we have improved holder checking in Mastercam 2023. Holder checking has always been aware of the stock model, but it was only aware of the stock model that was within the customer's boundary. When Titan CNC was machining the Octopus part on their multi-axis machine, my phone rang, and we got some feedback on a holder collision that they caught because our simulation it's well capable of catching mistakes before the machine. And we looked into it and we were confused because we knew holder checking is aware of stock. But what we didn't realize was the holder checking is aware of stock within the boundary. So we don't pay attention to the stock outside of the boundary. And that's safe for the tool, but that wasn't safe for the holder. So that feedback, pushed us in a direction, and we realized, okay, We need to pay attention to the entire stock model, regardless of the boundary. And that adds complexity and processing time because there's more data to process. But we went in and we made a couple of changes and the product has been improved overall. Now the holder is aware of the entire stock model, even if a customer is only machining a very small piece of it within an isolated boundary. Rest roughing with stock models has been streamlined. In Mastercam 2023, all that is required is the machining model you're machining and the stock model. We're going to do something logically with just that information because that's all we should need is the part and the stock. We should approach it logically. And that's what Mastercam 2023 will do. There's no need to ensure that your Z heights are set a certain way. There's no need to have a machining boundary that was big enough to let the tool get to the stock. There's no worry about all those extra little things. All you have to do in Mastercam 2023 is pick the machining model and the stock model, and that's it. There's nothing else to do. So in Mastercam 2023, machining with stock models is the cleanest, simplest experience that it's ever been. And I think that our existing customers are going to appreciate that moving forward. And new customers, it's going to be very easy to learn. So for me, as we approach the actual release of Mastercam 2023, I'm excited. I love when we release it. I sit back and I hope that the customers, you know, see the value in it that we know we put into it. There's so much thought goes into it, and I just hope that it just helps our customers in their day-to-day lives, you know, going to work, punching in, you know, and building the world. And that's everything we do. This is Mastercam 2023.